Croatia. It was a great day yesterday, and today maybe the same, so I hope for Hilde she will beat the French girl.
Yeah, you said it, Hilde Drexler. She's fighting in the semi-final now against Ekpenegnu Paris from France, and it's the semi-final. Yeah. Yes, and yeah, we will see. I will be anxious about it, and of course, the coach will be there too. Udo Kwelmers is here to support her.
Yes, we are happy he's back because he had some troubles with his passport. But yesterday, Hilde coached me, and in the final block, Lupo was my coach, so we had no problems. We found the right tactic, and today Udo is back, and I hope they will both do the best.
Yeah, I hope so too. So I think there will be just a few minutes before they start with the first semi-final in 63. The second semi-final in 63 will be Chinese Su Jua against the Spanish Aguirre de Ruan. So we will be anxious about that fight. And then we will follow with the men under 73. But until there, there's still a little bit of time. And when I look to the crowd, there's still a few more people than the morning. And I also spoke to Sheldon, and we thought maybe it is a little bit hard when you start to fight in the morning. There's nobody in the hall. What a feeling is that for a Grand Prix?
Yeah, I think I didn't realize because I was so focused on the competition. So I didn't realize if there is much crowd or less crowd. But during the final block, there was a good atmosphere. They had some really nice music, so I didn't have to push myself. It was the right atmosphere to fight the final, and I think that's the perfect. Preparation for the final.
That's perfect, because also that you had the concentration from the beginning of the competition. Also, there weren't so many people to support you.
Also, we are a small team, so we just had one or two persons which shouted to us and tried to push ourselves. But so when there is no crowd, two people are shouting, you can hear
them. Enough. That's enough. They give you advices, and then everything is fine. I wondered one thing. Between two fights, one fight end and the next begin, there's always a long break. And that the new fighters come in. How was it in your situation? The people before, the judo player before you, the fight ended, and you had to wait until they were away from the mat. How was it? Because there was always a little break, you know, between the fights.
Yeah, but it was no problem. I think it was really a good thing, but I didn't realize it.
Yeah. But it was all planned. There were no stress, or they looked for some competitors.
They were really nice and relaxed. Everybody knew what to do, and they gave you the advice, and then you had to go inside. So I think
it was perfect for the competitors. Very nice. And I also saw a lot of judo players who had another judo gi. What was the problem? Do you know that?
Very strict, because we all had the sign of the world championships, so there had been two different kinds of sponsor.
That was the problem.
And we had to take all of it off, because our names and the country names and the sponsor was on one plate.
Yeah, that was the reason. We were wondering. So now we're gonna watch the first semi-final of the day. Here the competitors come. This is Drexler from Austria, and she has to fight against Ekpenegnu from France. The first semi-final now, under 63 kilograms.
The young French girl, she was a French champion last week and beat Eman in the final.
Okay.
So she's really very strong and very aggressive.
Yes, yeah. Okay, so
not
we will see.
Not easy to fight.
Yeah.
But Hilde is very motivated. She had some very good results in the last few weeks. Mm-hmm. She won the Swedish Open and the Finnish Open. So now she's in good shape, and I hope she can do well.
Yeah, and that also gives her confidence. Yeah,
yes, for competition
like
necessary
this.
Necessary for her.
Yeah. So Hilde is gonna fighting left-handed. Sorry, right-handed. Yes.
And the French girl left.
Yeah. So does she have a special tactic or against her, or what did Udo said to her? Do you know that?
I think she should be very aggressive in the gripping, so she can have a strong right-handed grip against her left grip, because now you can see she has really a lot of power for her age.
Yes.
And she wants to move her to her own side, not to step out of the mat.
Yeah. The grip is the most important.
Yes.
Otherwise.
And of course the French girl will be very tactical.
Yeah.
Prepared.
Like all French girls, yeah.
Like all.
Yeah.
The French coaches are very clever.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. And Hilde is very tall for her category, huh? So now she gets the first warning in the fight.
Yeah, you can see the French girl is always breaking the grip from inside.
Yeah.
And grip around the arm of Hilde.
Yeah. I don't know, she must be careful in Nevasa. But yeah.
Hilde is very strong in Nevasa.
Yeah. She also likes it, yeah?
She also likes it. You're right.
Oh, Usugawa Haregoshi, yeah.
Is strong.
Yeah. Now she tries to take her into the mat. You're also very, very tall for your category, yeah, aren't you?
I think some of the Austrian girls are taller than other ones, like Claudia Heil.
Yeah, the same.
She was 6'3", very tall. Hilde is very tall.
That's right, yeah. Claudia, very tall for 6'3". And do you think that it's a good thing when you're tall, or what do you think?
For me, it's a good thing because I'm used to it, but otherwise,
yeah,
the small and explosive, powerful women, they have
can be dangerous.
Yeah, they have much more to put inside and to go underneath you, your hip. So it's always dangerous for me to fight the small girls.
And you see, Hilde must use their tall, their size.
Yes.
Yeah,
because
try
if she
to be upright.
If her head breaks and she is too low with the upper body,
bent over,
it looks bad.
Oh, Sumigaeshi,
nice.
Nice Sumigaeshi attempt. So there's still no score.
Somebody tried to explain me the French girl is very aggressive in the tachibaza, but has no clue in nevasa. But then I saw against Willeborze. She did Ippon in the last second, so I'm sure the French girl, knows what to do.
Yeah, she's not so bad in Nevasa.
And she is flexible.
Yeah,
I saw it. She's flexible in each direction, so she can escape.
That makes her more dangerous. It's not the best posture.
No.
But it's also not easy when your opponent wants have you, you know, and push you, and then that's not easy to upright again. Oh, Jim! Oh, nice!
Oh, was nice.
Yes.
Yuko.
Yeah. Nice. I also thought maybe Yuko, but they didn't give.
But today in Hilde's first fight, it was a little bit the same against the Azerbaijanian.
Yes.
She had no good grip, but she did one reaction to a counter technique and threw Ippon. So maybe she can surprise the French girl once more.
Would be nice.
Would be nice.
We just saw some kind of counter from the French girl. For a counter for Uchimata. There she must be careful. Oh, Himuro Tsuyonaga.
Yeah, she's a good counter technique. She's good in counter techniques also.
Yeah, and there you saw Hilde lost his grip. Lost her grip and couldn't control her anymore, and then maybe it was much more easily.
Flexible move from the French girl, and
yeah,
could be dangerous.